Welcome to Viavi Solutions series on the T-Bird 2000 OTDR platform, Episode 1, Device Overview. This episode will help users understand the basic controls and ports of the T-Bird 2000 mainframe. This video includes the following topics: charging the device, optical ports and test options, input and output ports, and device controls. Charging the mainframe. The T-Bird 2000 contains an internal battery. To charge the device, use the included power adapter. Attach the power charger to the power supply input port on the side of the unit. The charge light will turn red to indicate the unit is charging. Charge time is approximately 3.5 hours. Note that charging the unit while conducting tests will increase charge time to approximately 9.5 hours. Optical ports and test options. The T-Bird 2000's OTDR module can have up to two ports, including multimode and single mode. Multimode ports are denoted by orange coloring. Single mode ports will be either black or gray for UPC style ferrules or green for APC style ferrules. The OTDR adapter connection is interchangeable with the following types: SC, FC, and ST. An optical light source is also available on the test port for the wavelengths currently enabled on that module. The optical light source is a factory upgrade option. Additional optional optical tools are available for the mainframe, including a broadband power meter, visual fault locator, and probe microscopes via USB or wireless connection. Input and output ports. The T-Bird 2000 mainframe has two USB ports. These can be used to connect USB storage devices, fiber inspection probe microscopes, and Wi-Fi or Bluetooth dongles. The T-Bird 2000 also has an Ethernet RJ45 port for connecting to the internet to access the unit remotely via Smart Access Anywhere or VNC Viewer, access to Stratasync for data and asset management, as well as access to FTP data transfer services. Primary controls. The T-Bird 2000 features hard keys and soft keys. The hard keys are the physical buttons on the front of the unit. These can be used to access everything from the home screen to navigating through results. Soft keys are context-sensitive touchscreen buttons that will change depending on the current function activated on the unit. First, we'll go over the hard keys. The T-Bird 2000 has an on-off button in the lower left-hand corner of the front display. The home button returns the user to the home screen of the unit. The navigational keypad. The arrows can be used to navigate through the menu. The arrows can also be used to move the cursor on traces. The Enter button is used to validate actions such as selecting test functions. It can also be used to auto-zoom traces. The Cancel button will deactivate the current selected function. When the user is on the home screen, they can use the navigational pad to move the cursor over the top of the function. Then they press the Cancel button. This will deactivate the function. The File button allows you to access the File Explorer to create directories, view, and load recorded data. The Setup button switches to the Setup menu for the current test function selected. The Results button will switch to the Results page of the current test selected. The T-Bird 2000 has a large touchscreen that performs a variety of functions, including selecting icons or tests, context-sensitive soft keys while in certain menus, navigating in setup menus, zooming in on traces, moving cursors on traces, and selecting events in SmartLink Mapper View. This concludes the device overview. Our next video will show you how to set up a basic OTDR trace test.
Please leave a thumbs up if you like this video. We have playlists with more tutorials on this product and others over on our channel page. Subscribe and click the bell if you want to be notified when we release new content. For more information on this product and other Viavi Solutions offerings, please visit our website. You can find the link in the video description below. Thanks for watching.